Welcome to the Corp Vault channel. In this video, we will discuss about deduplication database backup. When you create a storage policy with deduplication enabled, the DDB backup subclient is automatically created under the file system agent, on the media agent, where the DDBs are hosted. The DDB is protected by the DDB backup subclient. This subclient backs up the active DDBs on a media agent. It does not back up any sealed DDB. If multiple DDBs are hosted on the media agent, only one DDB backup subclient is created for the media agent, and the same DDB backup job backs up all active DDBs available on the media agent. Let's review what does the DDB backup subclient manages. It automatically defines the DDB as the backup content. It uses the same deduplicated storage policy as that of the DDB for backup. It performs only full backups of the DDB, and the backed up data is sent to the backup media, configured to the storage policy. It backs up only active partitions of the DDB, which are not sealed or non-offline. If any sealed or offline partitions of DDB occur during a DDB backup job, the backup process skips those partitions and backs up only active partitions. The DDB backup is automatically associated with a system-created DDB backup schedule policy. This schedule policy runs full backup job every day at 4 p.m., every 24 hours. You can modify the schedule if you want to. DDB backups are supported on all storage libraries that is disk, cloud, and tape. However, note that DDB backups are not recommended on archive object storage, like S3 Glacier, Deep Archive, Azure Archive, and Oracle Archive. Couple of important points to note are: do not delete the DDB subclient. If the DDB subclient is deleted accidentally, you can replace or recreate it. Do not configure DDB partitions on multiple mount points that point to the same directory, as the DDB backup job with snapshot will fail, because creating multiple snapshots of the same drive is not supported. Let's discuss DDB backup process. What happens when the DDB backup job starts? All communication to the active DDB is paused for a few seconds. The information in memory is committed to disk to ensure that the DDB is in a quiescent state. The DDB process creates a snapshot of the volume by using VSS for Windows or LVM for Linux. The Linux platform also supports Extended 3 file system and Veritas Volume Manager file systems. For better performance on snapshots, please see our other video on DDB performance tuning. After the snapshot is created, all the communication to the DDB is resumed, and the DDB is automatically backed up from that snapshot. If VSS or LVM snapshot fails, the DDB backup fails with these error messages. For Windows, the error code description says, "The job has failed because the VSS snapshot could not be created." And for Unix, the description says, "Snap not supported on the volumes holding DDB paths, or we fail to take snapshot." However, you can configure to use live volume backup of DDB. After the successful DDB backup, the snapshot is deleted. During this stage, the job controller displays the DDB backup job in a running state. Couple of points to note are: the DDB backup jobs are resilient to the individual partitions in a deduplication database. When a DDB backup job is run, the partitions that are successfully backed up point to the current job, whereas the partitions that failed still point to the previous successful DDB backup job. When a DDB backup job is run again later, the failed partitions are backed up first, followed by the partitions that were backed up successfully in the previous DDB backup job. By default, the DDB backup jobs are disabled for the auxiliary copy operation, and these jobs appear as unavailable when viewed from the primary copy. To allow or prevent the copying of DDB backup jobs during the AUX copy operation. Go to Control Panel. Select Media Management. Under Media Management Configuration window, select Auxiliary Copy tab. Change the value of parameter, allow auxiliary copy for deduplication database backup jobs, from 0, disabled, to 1, enabled. Click OK. Once it is enabled, then you will be able to copy DDB backup jobs during the AUX copy operation. Let's discuss how DDB backup pruning process works. DDB backup pruning works differently on an active DDB and unsealed DDB. For an active DDB, DDB backups do not follow the retention settings on the associated storage policy copy. By default, the DDB backup job is pruned if it does not hold the latest backup of any active DDB. However, you can configure the option to retain extra DDB backups for every partition parameter, to retain multiple DDB backups for each partition. In the Control Panel, select Media Management. Under Media Management Configuration window, select a Duplication tab. Change the value of option to retain extra DDB backups for every partition. You can change the value between range of 1 and 4. The number that you specify is the number of DDB backups that can be retained for each partition. Which means, if multiple DDB backups for each partition are retained, and the most recent DDB backup is corrupted, then you can use one of the retained DDB backups for DDB reconstruction. For example, if a DDB backup job includes 4 DDBs, then the job is pruned only when all 4 of the DDBs are backed up again. If the next DDB backup operation backs up only 2 DDBs, because the other 2 were offline during the backup operation, the previous backup job will not be pruned until the remaining 2 DDBs are also backed up. For a sealed DDB, the DDB backup subclient does not back up a DDB after it has been sealed. When a DDB is sealed, all existing DDB backup jobs that contain the sealed DDB are retained indefinitely. To allow pruning for these DDB backup jobs, in the Control Panel, select Media Management. Under Media Management Configuration window, select Data Aging tab. In the option Retain DDB backups of sealed stores, type 0, to allow pruning of DDB backup jobs of the sealed DDB. Click OK. Once the Retain DDB backups of sealed stores option is disabled, the next data aging job will prune the DDB backup jobs of the sealed DDB. We will end this video here. Stay tuned to the channel for more videos. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.